In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries by calling to mind our sins. I confess
to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most serious fault. Therefore, I ask from the sanctuary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray and pray to the Lord our God.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. When Abraham prostrated himself, God spoke to him, "My covenant with you is this. You are to become the father of a host of nations. No longer shall you be called Abraham. Your name shall be Abraham, for I am making you the father of a host of nations. I will render you exceedingly fertile. I will make nations of you. Kings shall stem from you. I will maintain my covenant with you and your descendants after you throughout the ages as an everlasting pact, to be your God and the God of your descendants after you. I will give to you and to your descendants after you the land in which you are now staying, the whole land of Canaan, as a permanent possession, and I will be their God." God also said to Abraham, "On your part, you and your descendants after you must keep my covenant throughout the ages." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Look to the Lord in his strength, seek and serve him constantly. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered. You, descendants of which he entered into with Abraham, and by his oath to Isaac. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. If today you hear his voice, pardon not your hearts.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever keeps my word will never see death." So the Jews said to him, "Now we are sure that you are possessed. Abraham died, as did the prophets, yet you say, whoever keeps my word will never taste death. Are you greater than our father Abraham, who died, or the prophets, who died? What do you make yourself out to be?" Jesus answered, "If I glorify myself, my glory is worth nothing. But it is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say, 'He is our God.' You do not know him, but I know him. And if I should say that I do not know him, I would be, like you, a liar. But I do know him, and I keep his word. Abraham, your father, rejoiced to see my day. He saw it and was glad." So the Jews said to him, "You are not yet 50 years old, and you have seen Abraham." Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, before Abraham came to be, I am." So they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid and went out of the temple area. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the time of our Lord, in the ancient world, death was a common reality, a very, very, very common reality. And not just for the poor. The rich, the well-fed, the well-connected died also very, very frequently. It was part of daily life. Death was part of life, as death is part of life. So there are no illusions as we have today, as the great philosopher Descartes once wrote, that we are masters and possessors of nature. We are not masters and possessors of nature, as these recent events show. For our Lord spoke, as he did in today's gospel, that if we follow his word, we keep his word, we will never see death. They have real power, affecting people very profoundly. So he does offer true life, eternal life, life forever and ever. And that is true now as then. We've come to the illusion for many of us that we do control nature. We are the masters and possessors of nature. And we've done wonderful things, extraordinary things. We are God's gift, the crown of creation. We are an image of the great Lord himself, his intelligence and power and creativity. But this world is not enough. It never meant to be enough. It never meant to be our end. Eternity with God is our end. And in moments like this, in seasons like this, the season of Lent, of reflection, of self-awareness, we come to the conclusion of who we really are, what our nature really is, of what we're made for, and what we're not made for. Let's use this opportunity of Lent, let's use the conditions of our present time to reflect upon our eternal destiny and to follow our eternal destiny.
Oh.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these sacrificial offerings, that they may profit our conversion and the salvation of all the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, who through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart, confessed infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, in the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the death of the Lord until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to this holy sincerity, together with Francis our Pope, and Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your grace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints, what pleased you throughout the ages, we
Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may we always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait with blessed hope on the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of your now
and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with her will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace and love with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's love each other, a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by the same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you make us partakers of life eternal. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Before the Mass is ended,
thanks be to God.